Hello and welcome to Yes We Can, Learning Opportunity in Crisis. Today we are going to study Chapter 6 of NCERT Class 5 EVS, Every Drop Counts. In this chapter, we are going to learn about what it means when we say every drop counts. Then, why is water conservation more important than ever? Next, causes of scarcity of water. What is rainwater harvesting? Unique water conservation systems in India. Ways in which people manage water today. And more efficient use of limited water supplies. So let us start our chapter, Every Drop Counts. But before we start this chapter from your book, which begins from page number 51, stating about a lake in Jaisalmer, Rajasthan, it is very important for you to know some facts so that you understand why this chapter is started by describing about this lake and what is its importance today. Then we'll connect to your book. First of all, you should understand what it means when we say every drop counts. Most of us take the water we use every day for granted. We turn on the tap and as long as plenty of clean, clear water flows from the faucet, we do not give water much thought. Water is our most precious resource. But you should also know that it is a limited resource. You know, water is very important in our everyday lives. We use water for bathing, cleaning, cooking, drinking, flushing, washing the car and keeping the garden green. Today, we use more water than ever before. As population continues to grow, more water is required to meet demands. Also, modern technology has produced many conveniences such as automatic dishwashers, washing machines and sprinklers that make many of our tasks easier but are subject to more water waste. Water may be overused on people, animals, land for recreational activities without any care about the effects that it may have on the world around them. Water usage has increased 6 times in the past 100 years and will double again by 2050. Pollution of water can be anything from oil, chemicals, fecal matters, industrial waste, pesticides, fertilizers, which makes the water unfit for human consumption. Then groundwater is being depleted. And then climate is also changing due to global warming. Dry areas are getting drier and irregular rain is so unpredictable. Did you know? While most of the planet is covered in water, 97% is salt water, 2% polar ice caps and only 1% is available fresh water for human consumption. Meaning, water conservation is more important than ever. Now, there is water scarcity crisis in India. Clean drinking water is scarce and there are millions of people across the globe who spent their entire day searching for it. Yet, people who have access to safe, clean drinking water take it for granted and don't use it wisely. It is important that we take some steps to reduce the high rate of water loss. Rainwater harvesting is one of the methods that can be used for water conservation. Now, what is rainwater harvesting? Rainwater harvesting is a technique of collection and storage of rainwater into natural reservoirs or tanks, rather than allowing it to just run off. In ancient India, every region in the country had its own traditional water harvesting techniques. Indians continued to build structures to catch, hold and store monsoon rainwater whenever and wherever it falls for the dry seasons to come. Modern India can learn a lot from traditional water conservation systems. To cope up with water crisis, the Indian government has started looking at means to revive the traditional systems of water harvesting in the country. And this chapter is all about traditional rainwater harvesting techniques. Now, we start your book. We start with Rajasthan. Water scarcity is a major problem in Rajasthan. It gets very little rainfall. Here it rains for only a few days in the entire year, sometimes not even that much. The rivers here do not have water all around the year. Let us first find out where is Rajasthan. This is the map of India and here is the state of Rajasthan. The problem of water scarcity in Jaisalmer, Rajasthan was solved 650 years ago by the ruler of Jaisalmer, King Ghadsi. One year there was no rain, not even for the basic needs. Now let us see where is Jaisalmer in Rajasthan. This is the map of India, here is the state of Rajasthan and this is Jaisalmer. King Ghadsi of Jaisalmer built a lake 650 years ago with the help of the people. Since King Ghadsi built the lake, it was called Ghadsi Sar. Sar means lake. All around the lake there are ghats with steps leading to the water, decorated verandas, large halls, rooms and much more. People came here to celebrate festivals and for programs of music and dance. Children came to study in the school on the ghat. The talab belonged to everyone and everyone took care to keep it clean. Rainwater collected in this lake spread over many miles. There were 9 interconnected lakes. It was made in such a way that when the lake was full, the extra water flowed into another lake at a lower level. When that too filled up, the extra water flowed into the next lake, still at a lower level. This way there were 9 interconnected lakes and all 9 lakes filled up. This rainwater could be used throughout the year. Thus, the problem of water was solved in Jaisalmer, Rajasthan. Today Ghadsi Sar is no more in use. Many new buildings and colonies have come up in between those 9 lakes. Now the water does not get collected in these lakes. Rainwater just flows away and is wasted. And now a surprise. Come on, let us go on a trip to Ghadsi Sar. Not only Ghadsi Sar, there are several ancient lakes in Rajasthan. Let us see some more ancient lakes in Rajasthan. The Anand Sagar Lake was constructed by Lanchi Bai, the Rani of Maharwal Jagami. Then Fateh Sagar Lake in Udaipur was built by Maharana Fateh Singh in 1888. Lake Pichola in Udaipur city of Rajasthan was created in the year 1362 AD. Anasagar Lake in Ajmer was built by Arnoraj Chauhan, Who was the grandfather of Prithviraj Chauhan? Besides Jaisalmer, many places in Rajasthan get very little rainfall. Yet, most of the villages in this area did not have a shortage of water. People knew that every drop of water was precious. One and all came together, be it a businessman or a laborer, to build structures to catch, hold and store monsoon rainwater for the dry seasons to come. So they constructed lakes, stepwells, johads, tankas. Stepwells were made to collect water. Water was everyone's need. One and all came together in this work, be it a businessman or a laborer. How amazing it is! Bawdies are typically rectangular shaped stepwells. The steps go down several stories deep. Instead of drawing the water up from the well, people could go down the steps and reach the water. That is why they are called step wells. These beautiful step wells typically have beautiful arches, carved motifs and sometimes rooms on their sides. Talabs are reservoirs that store water for household consumption and drinking purposes. A reservoir with an area less than 5 bighas is called a talai, and bigger lakes are called sagar or samand. Bawdies are unique ancient stepwells in the cities of Rajasthan. The water would percolate into the ground, raising the water table. Some water from the lake soaked into the ground and reached the wells and bawdies, that is stepwell. The soil of the area also became wet and fertile. Johads are small earthen check dams that capture and store rainwater. Due to check dams, underground water table raises, which helps to raise water in nearby wells. Tanka is a traditional rainwater harvesting technique of Thar desert region of Rajasthan. A tanka is a cylindrical underground pit into which rainwater from rooftops or courtyards flow. One method of rainwater harvesting is rooftop harvesting. Every house had a system to collect the rainwater. Look at the picture on your left. How do you think the rainwater that falls on the roof will reach the tank? The water collected on roof reaches the underground tank through the pipe which connects both of these. This is rooftop harvesting. It's raining. A pipe open from the top is fixed along the edges of the roof. You can see this pipe which is open from the top. Water flows down the pipe and is flowing down through the pipe into a tank. And this water is collected in the tank. As you can see, it's raining. Water is coming into the barrel. The barrel is full. There is a tap at the bottom of the barrel. You can take out the water into a bucket and use it. This is another video of rooftop harvesting in which the water is collected in underground tank. It's raining. Water is flowing through the open pipe fixed along the edges of the roof. And now the water is flowing down the solid pipe. Down to the underground pipe. It's flowing through the underground pipe. And now into the underground tank. The water is being collected in the underground tank for future use. More than 1,000 years ago, a traveler came to India from Uzbekistan. His name was Al-Biruni. Let us see where is Uzbekistan. This is world map and here is Uzbekistan. This is India, this is Pakistan, then Afghanistan. And here is Uzbekistan. Al-Biruni carefully observed and noted down the details of all that he saw. He wrote specially about the ponds of that time. He wrote, "The people here are very skilled at making ponds. My countrymen would be surprised to see them. They pile up huge rocks and join them with iron rods to build chabutaras. And what are chabutaras? Raised platforms all around the lake. Between these, there are rows of long staircases going up and down. The steps for going up and coming down are separate, so there is less crowding. Today, when we study history, we can learn a lot about those days from the writings of Al-Biruni. And this stamp came out in 1973, 1,000 years after his birth. Now let us see what kind of water arrangements were made for travelers in those days. Earlier, kings and rich merchants used to build piau for travelers where they could drink water. Drinking water was served for free at these piaus. Many stone carvings are also made near the place of drinking water. See, these all are called piaus. People also used to carry mashak, which was a leather bag used to store water. And nowadays people usually purchase packed drinking water or carry their own water bottles. Now let us learn about traditional rainwater harvesting in Uttarakhand. Here is a part of what is written in your book. Even today, people get water from very old lakes, dharas, step wells and nalas. Many customs and festivals are related to water. You have learnt about old lakes and step wells. Now, what are nalas and dharas? Nala dhara is the water lifeline of Uttarakhand. Nala is perhaps the most unique water storage system in Uttarakhand. It is a small structure with a roof which houses a naturally occurring underground spring and has steps that lead down to the underground spring. They are known as water temples in Uttarakhand. A common source of drinking water in Uttarakhand is the dhara. It is essentially a drinking water fountain. Water from springs or other sources is channeled out through carved outlets in the shape of either a simple pipe or animal face masks. Now let us see a nala of Uttarakhand. Many customs and festivals are related to water. At some places, whenever lakes get filled up with rainwater, the people gather around the lake to celebrate. See the bride of Uttarakhand in this picture. After getting married, she has come to the new village. She bows to the spring or the pond. Do you have some special pots for water at your place? Look at these beautiful copper pots. And the shining yellow pot of brass is seen in the other picture. Now, let us see the different ways in which people manage water today. In this picture, a Jal Board water tanker comes to their colony twice a day. They have to stand in a long queue to get water from the tanker. People at times have fights over water. Next, in this picture, they get water at home for half an hour. They fill this in a tank to use all day. Sometimes it is dirty. And this one, there is a hand pump nearby, but the water that they get from it is salty. They have to buy water for drinking. And in this picture, they get water from the canal itself. Next, they fill water from the well. The nearby well dried up a year ago. Now they have to walk far to reach the other well. They are not allowed to take water from some of these wells because of their caste. And in this, they get water from their taps all day long. So lucky. Next one, they have to put a motor to pump up the water from the bore well. But there is no electricity. So what to do? And this one, they have put a pump directly in the Jal Board pipeline. And they say now they don't have any problem. We have seen that nowadays people get water from taps, tankers, wells, hand pumps, canals, rivers and bore wells. Some people draw out water from the ground by deep bore wells. How far is it correct? This is a bore well. Bore wells are vertical drilled wells bored into an underground to extract water. Electrical pumps are used to pump out the water from the bore wells. Drawing water by bore wells is not a correct practice. Bore well gives hard water, which is not good for household purposes, and it affects the water level, causing decline in ground water level. It is not only depriving other people of water, but also affects the environment. Why do some people put a pump directly in the Jal Board pipeline? What problems would other people face due to this? Some people directly put a pump in the Jal Board pipeline to get supply of drinking water. Due to this, other people do not get sufficient water. Everyone has the right to live. Yet, is everybody getting enough water to live or even water to drink? Not everybody is getting enough water to live or even drink. Why is that some people have to buy drinking water? Should it be like this? Water on this earth is for one and all. Some people have to buy drinking water as drinking water is scarce and they do not get sufficient water supply due to the lack of drinking water in that area. Things should not be like this. This is a water bill. Look at it carefully and try to read. From which office has this bill come? Look here. This bill has come from Delhi Jal Board. Do you get a water bill at home? Find out from where it is sent. Those who get a water bill at home, the bill is sent from the water supply department of their city. Why do you think Delhi Sarkar, Government of Delhi is written under the Delhi Jal Board? Delhi Sarkar, Government of Delhi is written under Delhi Jal Board as it is run by the Government of Delhi. In whose name is this bill? How much money do they have to pay for each month? The bill is in the name of Muhammad Umar and Dr. Muhammad Shoaib. They have to pay a total amount of 368 rupees. Do you have to pay for water? How much? Is the rate of water different in different colonies? Ask your elders. The rate is the same in different colonies. Do you know that there are some groups dealing with water crisis? Yes, it can be done. There are some groups that work hard to bring water to the people of different areas. They ask the elders about the water arrangement in their times. They rebuild the old lakes and johads and also build new ones. Let us see how the group called Tarun Bharat Sangh helped Darki Mai. So this is the story of Darki Mai. This is Darki Mai. She lives in a village in the Alwar district of Rajasthan. The women of the village used to spend the entire day looking after their home and animals. Sometimes it took them all night to pull water from the well for the animals. In the summer, when the wells dried up, they had to leave the village. Darki Mai heard about this group and asked for help. Together, the people from the group and the village decided to make a lake. The problem of food and water for animals is now less. People get more milk. They have started earning more. I'll tell you more about Tarun Bharat Sangh. Tarun Bharat Sangh, a non-government organization run by Dr. Rajendra Singh, brings people together on the issues of water resources and has participated in the construction of johads, small scale reservoirs that help to harvest rain water. Dr. Rajendra Singh changed the course of his life from being a doctor of human bodies in Alwar to becoming a doctor of water bodies, gaining the title of the Water Man of India. But there is something that individuals can do to make more efficient use of limited water supplies and to make water conservation practices a part of everyday life. Water conservation involves reducing water waste. It does not mean doing without water. Water conservation involves changing water waste habits in home, repairing leaks in plumbing fixtures, and practicing water conservation can lower water bills. Look at this picture. It says producing one pair of jeans is equal to 10,000 liters of water. Can you imagine? Flushing a toilet is equal to 8 liters of water, and 5 minutes shower is equal to 35 liters of water. Now it's about doing your part. Turn off the tap while you brush your teeth. Check faucets and pipes for leaks. Use your dishwasher and clothes washer for only full loads. Verify that your home is leak free. Reduce the amount of time you spend on the shower. Whenever you see an open tap, close it instantly. Use cans to water the plants. Do not waste water. Turn off the tap while brushing your teeth. Turn off taps after use. Remember, if we each save a little, together we save a lot. Make every drop count. Now you know, the earth provides enough to satisfy every man's needs, but not every man's greed. A quote by Mahatma Gandhi. Do you remember the slogan, water on earth is for one and all? I had given you an assignment to think of some other such slogans and write slogans and draw nice posters. You have done it amazingly. Here are those. Must be feeling very happy. Here we finish our chapter. In this chapter, we have discussed and learnt a lot about what it means when we say every drop counts. Why is water conservation more important than ever? Causes of scarcity of water. What is rainwater harvesting? The traditional rainwater conservation systems in Rajasthan. And in that, we have learnt about Ghatsisar and 9 interconnected lakes, other ancient lakes in Rajasthan, stepwells, johads, bavdis and tankas. We have also learnt about rooftop harvesting, about Al-Biruni, a traveller from Uzbekistan, water arrangements made for travellers in those days. We have also done map work locating Rajasthan and Jaisalmer in Map of India and Uzbekistan in World Map. We have learnt about traditional rainwater harvesting in Uttarakhand, customs and festivals related to water, special pots for water, different ways in which people manage water today, water from the ground by deep borewells, then what individuals can do to make more efficient use of limited water supplies, about Tarun Bharat Sangh. And you have written wonderful slogans and drawn posters on Save Water. Worksheets are given at the end. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask me in the comment section. I'll reply as soon as possible. See you soon in next chapter. Keep watching and stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Do like and subscribe my channel. Yes, we can. Learning, opportunity in crisis. For more upcoming videos.